I do think innately, even if there's no reflection, the practice of putting yourself in a situation you were required to go into a sensory state, like at a survival level, is actually quite healthy for most of us, where our default state is to be in this sort of conceptual, like, narrative of what's happening and generating narratives for others and, you know, justifying our actions and judgment. To break out of that network, you can't really, like, judge your way or think your way out of a thinking network. So I think to just turn up the allocation of metabolic resources to sensory parts of the brain, which by definition reduces the amount of, or interferes with the allocation of resources to these sort of conceptual habit sustaining parts of the brain, is actually almost like an act of rebellion against a lot of the things that our culture are pushing us to do, to sort of homogenize our experience and to fit in. And so even without reflection, I think there's a bit of, and maybe you have this after surfing, like maybe it's like explicitly like, oh, I survived that. But also sometimes there's like a spaciousness. And I think it's because you've interfered with the network in our brain, like this default mode network that's trying to push us to know what's happening, to act on a habit, to be really efficient with how we use our minds, which are all important skills, but to take into an extreme, they kind of suck all the zest out of life. And so just resetting the balance a little, I think it happened without reflection. If you want to get to know like how your mind works and how you've been conditioned and what your habits are and whether you would choose them if you had a choice or sort of push against them, I think there has to be some intentionality there generally, right? To start to notice, oh, these are the patterns of how I respond when I get provoked or when I feel really up or really down. And I think that's where some of the contemplative training or having a guide or therapist, coach, friend you can disclose, a diary entry you can look back onto, like that's where these kind of technologies of self, if you want to think of them that way, might be really, really important, because otherwise you're just hoping spontaneously to have these insights. And if you're really trying not to fall off your board and get into cold Lake Ontario, like, you know, you might not have the bandwidth to do that in that moment. So it's a bit of both, right? That is an immediate benefit for just opposing a network that pushes you into habit and efficiency by doing something super energy intensive that's about taking in new ambiguous information and trying to, you know, deal with it on the fly. And if you were to be in a bit more of a sedate situation where you had the resources to notice things that are familiar and notice patterns, then there'd be a chance for deeper insights. So you want relief from the dominant status quo story, or you want to actually learn new things about yourselves? If it's the latter, probably having some guidance or some intentional reflection is going to be really important. Yeah, and yet, of course, people are drawn to these experiences. And like, why climb up this rock? Like, yeah, or something, right? Why put yourself through all this stuff? And, you know, I think the conventional platitude is it's like this dopamine rush. It's just rewarding. And then, you know, you get used to it, so you need even more. But it doesn't follow the profile of someone who's just chasing dopamine, like, which is like an addiction profile. So you don't, it's not like, oh, I didn't go to work today because I was climbing rocks again. And, you know, other pleasures have lost all meaning. I think generally it's more of like a feeling of more, I'm engaged, I'm alive, and I'm actually more open to other things, which is the opposite of like of a drug addiction profile, where you slowly lose the ability to respond to anything other than the drug stimulus. So, yeah, I think it's, just talking to people and having, you know, done my own experience with sports and things like that, it feels like there's more than going on. And actually, it's not always intrinsically rewarding when you're worried. Like, I started learning to snowboard relatively late in life in my 30s, which is very painful. But also, like, that feeling of, like, I don't know if I can do this, but I think I can. Like, it's not crazy, so I'm sort of have knowledge, but I'm pushing the boundary of, like, well, I don't know if I can apply this. And then even if, you know, there's some bruises along the way, that feeling of, like, wow, I learned something about myself, and I do feel like things are changing, and I'm not just always trying to consolidate and be safe. Like, there's a lot of other things happening. And then where I'm not as much of an expert is also just the physiology. Like, there's the physiology of exercise, of course, which probably is doing a lot of things from the bottom up to clean out our bodies, and including, you know, our brains. And so there's probably a lot of explanations there. I think the flow state is like the culmination or the realization of a mass amount of practice and expertise. And so it's really the position where your predictions, your expectations of reality are kind of just beautifully lining up with how reality is unfolding. So the sensations coming in and the predictions for what they should look like are just meeting, and there's almost like no error. And that feeling of no error, but it's like you doing it, is where, like, I think our feeling of presence comes from. That like what I expect, like the way I think of myself and the feedback I'm getting from the world are just aligning beautifully. And I think it happens especially in athletics or dance and things, is because these are situations where you're preparing to have this kind of perfect match, right? You're not just like, I'm just going to get out there and hear the music and see what happens. It's like, I have a very well-defined expectation for what I'm supposed to be doing with my body, and it's actually happening. And so when you have really strong expectations and really strong sensory input and they're aligning, I think that's the recipe for a flow state. I think when we start talking about pushing the boundary, which you probably need to do in practice to achieve things you can't do when at the start of practice, or happens in like a competitive situation where you're really trying to do something maybe you haven't done before, now we're almost trying to set a prediction for us that's outside of what we've already experienced, and we're trying to ratchet up like our efforts so that the information coming back up again creates a match, but it's a match that's not familiar. And I think the way I would talk about that, if I had to add a academic term, and I do as an academic, it would be more like agency. And I think both of these things make for a fulfilling, meaningful life. Presence, so when you're able to be in states where things are playing out exactly as you expected are occurring, and the knowledge system is a great predictor of reality. And agency, when you're trying to go affect some change out in the world and waiting to see that you did that successfully, are sort of the inside and outside sides of the meaningfulness, or I'm a person, I'm actually here in the world kind of coin. Agency is about trying to send something out into the world, and with an expectation that is sort of yet to be realized and hoping it's going to happen. I think maybe I'm drawing too stark a dissociation, but in presence is more, I think, the product of expertise being like rewarded with reality being like, yep, you got the model right this time. And like, isn't it cool to not have to update again? Because like you already have it, right? I guess that's all I'd have to say about that. It's about whether you're trying to grow and learn more, or you're trying to almost like exploit, that might have a negative context, but like reap the benefits of having carefully already constructed a model of how the world might be and with yourself in it.